So most closings happen 45 to 60 days after offer acceptance. But sometimes there's complications. The seller might need additional time to pack because they have a lot of stuff and they've been living at the place for 50 years. Maybe they need to find a new home to buy. So there's extenuating circumstances where we need something called a use and occupancy. Well, today's video is all about what a use and occupancy is, when you need to use it, and how it all works. If you guys don't know me, my name is Sage Jankwitz. I'm a realtor based in Cambridge and Somerville, Massachusetts. I've closed over 300 transactions in the last 3 years. If you guys like this content, please take a second to hit that subscribe button. If you guys have questions, hit me up by text, hit me up in the comments, and yeah, that all sounds good. So let's start at the very beginning. What is a use and occupancy? A use and occupancy allows either party to occupy the property for a period of time post-closing. Cambridge and Somerville, the most common scenario is the seller needs additional time to occupy the property after closing. And so usually this will be a period of up to maybe 60 days post-closing for the seller to kind of get their stuff together, whether it's identifying a new property, packing, moving, all that good stuff. Now let's take a second to go over the terms of a use and occupancy, okay? There's typically a number of elements that make up the use and occupancy, and I'm gonna break them down for you guys right now. The first piece of the use and occupancy is the term. In other words, how long will the seller occupy the property post-closing? And most banks, just so you know, will not allow beyond 60 days. Occasionally we'll go a little bit beyond that, but generally speaking, banks will not loan to a buyer who's looking to make this their primary residence if the seller is planning on staying for more than 60 days. So usually you have a hard stop at around 60-ish days. The next part of the use and occupancy is usually the notification period. And this is the period prior to closing where the seller says, okay, I'm gonna need to use this use and occupancy for sure. And so sometimes right out of the gate, they know they need to do that and they provide notification right away. They write things in such a way where it's just a done deal. Other times it can be written in such a way where they say, you know, by X days prior to closing, the seller must notify the buyer in writing that they would like to use this use and occupancy. If they don't make that notification within that time period, then they're out of luck. The next is the payment period, because let's remember here, the buyer at this point has closed on the property, the seller is now living in it, but the buyer is still responsible for everything related to the property. They're paying for the mortgage and the property taxes and the water and sewer bill. And so they want to most likely be compensated by the seller. And so it depends on the deal itself in terms of what the buyer will allow the seller. And it will vary a bit depending on a lot of different dynamics. Most commonly, the starting off place is what is the total cost that the buyer has to cover? Say it's $5,000 a month all in. That's usually a good starting off place. Sometimes these amounts are determined by fair market rent. Sometimes the buyer will give a break to the seller if they want to be flexible because they felt good about some other parts of the transaction. So it will really vary a bit here, but hopefully this provides a little bit of insight into how you might think about the payment amount from both the sell side and the buy side. And then beyond that, there are some additional specifics that go into a use and occupancy. Those are generally hammered out between the buyer's attorney and the seller's attorney. And then of course, the attorneys will meet with their clients and explain any questions and just like a general breakdown of how this thing works. So hopefully this was a little helpful. Hopefully, if you decide to put in an offer or if you're a seller, if you hear about a use and occupancy now, you understand a little bit about what this actually means, at least on a high level. If you guys have questions, hit me up on Calendly and I'll see you guys next time.